Thank you very much, Doug. Let's go ahead. The objectives of this study were assessing the budgetary effectiveness of the project of oil production increase by one of the largest Russian oil companies. And in the framework of this study by budgetary efficiency, we understood the increase in revenues to the of the consolidated budget of Russia as a result of 1 ruble of tax benefits provided to an oil company. You know that all oil companies in all countries is very poor, because therefore they very like to have tax benefits from government. And second objective is a calculation of the multiplier effect of this project, calculated as the increase in gross output and GDP of Russian economy in the forecast period per ruble of investment made in the project. So, to assess the effectiveness of implementation of any and including large investment projects, 2 different approaches are possible. The first was the first approach is traditional, and Tatiana Novikova told a lot today about this approach, when you calculate different kind of well-known indexes like internal rate of return, NPV, payback period, etc. And in this approach, you can try to take into account impact of the particular investment project on other enterprises, which has a production connections this this project. But anyway, it's impossible if the project quite big one. It's impossible to take into account all connections using this approach. Therefore, second one is based on intersectoral analysis of the consequences of the project. And in this case, the data of input-output tables are used, and the use of this information to analyze the impact of extractive industries on the development of a national economy has been undertaken by many authors, but usually this is a research of impact of total industry, investment in total industry, say coal industry or oil industry, but not a lot of research tried to estimate the impact of particular project on the development of the total country. In this case, in framework of this approach, and this approach allows us to estimate the absolute increase in GDP and gross output of the national economy associated with implementation of the project, as well as its impact on the dynamics of production in other sectors. This is the idea. So, schematic representation of the impact of oil companies' project on the development of Russian economy. The increase of investment in fixed assets in framework of the particular project of oil company. I don't tell the title of this company because it was a real project. So this investment impact on increase of production of the oil company and oil industry itself compared this its development without this project. And it is one of the reasons of increase of GO, gross output, and GDP increase. So increase of investment in particular project impact on the increase in production in the related industry, so-called effect of inter-industry relation, and the increase in production of construction and engineering as a result of the implementation of the project of oil company. And it is again an impact on gross output and GDP growth. But increase in a related industry is a reason of increasing of income and expenses of the consolidated budget, in our case consolidated budget of Russian Federation. And the result of this increase is a growth of aggregate demand of the total economy, and this is a third channel of increasing gross output and GDP as a result of implementation of the particular investment project. So we used the dynamic input-output model, which has been developed at Institute of Economics of Siberian branch of Russian Academy of Sciences and at Novosibirsk State University. The model includes 32 sectors producing means of production and services that provide intermediate consumption, and corresponding 32 sectors that produce consumer goods and services that provide household consumption. And the list of branches of this model includes oil production. And oil production includes production of crude oil and associated gas, extraction of fraction from associated gas. So this project directly impact on production level in this industry. I mean oil production. So a feature of used dynamic IO model is that it explicitly takes into account investment legs in all industries. Another significant feature is that machine building industry and construction sector in the dynamic model are divided into two parts, so-called capital created and non-capital created parts. For example, machine building industry is divided into production of machinery and equipment and non-capital creating engineering. What does it mean? Production of parts and weapons. The same in construction. In this model, production of capital creating industry, investments in fixed assets and fixed assets put in service are linked. This is a peculiarity of this model. And such a link has been fully implemented in relation to the process of production of fixed assets, of course, in all industry, including oil industry. In all industries, including oil industry. Information base for calculation, data from System of National Accounts of Russia, and input-output tables for 2015, data from oil company about main parameters of the investment project. An information base for dynamic IO model was built at prices of 2015. And the calculation results were converted to 2018 prices using GDP deflator for the period 2016-2018. Baseline of calculations. The total investment in the project will be from this year, 2019, to 2033. The total investment in the project for the entire forecast period in 2018 prices was 790 billion rubles, or about $12.2 billion. This is investment to drilling additional wells, additional development of existing fields, oil fields, the acquisition of equipment and development of production infrastructure of oil company. Increase in oil production by a total volume was about 245 million tons. The increase of sales in prices of 2018 for the total period will amount to 3,132 billion rubles, or about $48 billion. And the oil company is asking the Russian government for benefits from payments for the mineral extraction tax for the period of the implementation of the project in amount of $5.6 billion. And we assume that tax rates in the forecast period will be stable and correspond to the values of 2019. Main assumptions of the calculations. The basis of calculations was an optimistic version of the dynamics of Russian economy. What does it mean? It means a smooth, crisis-free trajectory of dynamics of gross output and GDP of Russian economy in the period under consideration. Because the purpose of this study was not to forecast crisis. The use of a more pessimistic variant for the development of Russian economy will lead to some reduction in effects of the project, but will not fundamentally change them. To complete the assessment of economic effect of the implementation of the project, we took into account the impact on the economy of additional budget revenues directly generated by the project. It was assumed that these additional revenues will be used as they become available for development of the economy in form of investments. And this assumption is consistent with plans for implementation of national projects, which our government began to implement this year. And based on the data of Center for Resources Economics of Institute of Economics of Siberian branch of Russian Academy of Sciences, it was assumed that all types of taxes in price of oil sold for export amounted to 57%, and in price of oil sold in domestic market, we're about 72%. Very important figures. Some main points of analysis of results of calculations. Firstly, it's necessary to say that impact of the project on the development of Russian economy in the period under consideration at macro level is very limited. Total GDP for the period 2019-2033, according to the forecasts, with the inclusion of the project, is growing by 0.8% compared with the forecast without the project. Total investment in the same period, according to forecasts with the inclusion of the project compared with the forecast without it, increases by about 0.6%, so very small. It is understandable because it's a big project, but only one. And the comparison of values of absolute macroeconomic indicators in the forecast with and without the project allows us to evaluate the multiplier effects of the oil company's project. Gross output increase for 2019-2033 in prices of 2018 is 3,626 billion rubles. GDP increased by 2,095 billion rubles. So, given that the total investment in the project, the total investment is 790 billion rubles, the multiplier of oil companies' investments in terms of gross output is 4.6 times, and in terms of GDP, 2.7 times. But let's move to this graph a little bit later. So this is the multipliers for gross output for GDP. This is another multiplier. This is we calculated multiplier of tax benefits. So total increase in tax revenue for the forecast variant is the project divided by the amount of tax benefits received the oil company. And this multiplier is 2. And well, let's come back to this graph. But there is some peculiarity, quite big peculiarity of this project. You see, this is graph the difference between increases of gross output as a whole. Production is gross output as a whole. This is a black curve. Production of means of production and intermediate services. This is a increase. So this is a red curve. And production of consumer goods and services. This is a blue curve. Inversions with and without the oil company's project. It does not mean that production of consumer goods and services decreased. This is a difference between increases for both cases. Next point in analysis of results is that the oil industry is a highly capital intensive sector of economy. And according to our estimates, in 2015, the ruble of manufactured products in oil industry accounted for 2.36 rubles of fixed assets. In the Russian economy as a whole, for ruble of gross output, this indicator was 1.1. Well, so 2 times in oil industry is 2 times higher compared to total economy. And the next important thing is that this industry is connected with construction services related to oil production, pipe production services for production, transmission and distribution of electricity, wholesale services, and pipeline transplantation. And all this industry mainly produce manufactured goods and services. This is this explain this difference in increase which we have seen on this figure 2. Well, Doug, don't worry. I'll try to accelerate the process of my analysis. So this is just information about growth rate in both variants and difference in growth rate and difference in total amount of gross output for different industry, and rose color is negative. So negative increase. So for example, you see that say, in education or in health and care, social services, growth rate approximately the same, because you divided 2033 output on 2018 year growth output. But because in the beginning of period, resources is go from services to oil industry, the total amount of gross output in industries which produce consumer goods and services for the total period is less than without this project. Well, key conclusions. Implementation of this investment project is provision of tax benefits to the company in the period 2019-2033 generally positively affects on the development of Russian economy. In the economy as a whole, the additional gross output increase will amount 3,627 billion rubles. GDP increase will amount to 1,095 billion rubles. A positive impact of the project on the Russian economy, I would like to underline this point, is possible only if the additional income of consolidated budget received from the project is used for investment purposes. In the absence of investment of additional budget revenues, the result of project will be a simple redistribution of resources from sectors of the economy that from the final consumption of households to sectors that produced manufactured goods. Moreover, in the variant with the project, the gross output and GDP will not necessarily increase compared to the forecast variant without the project. As a result of study, the multiplier effects of the project for the Russian economy as a whole were evaluated. We already discussed these multipliers. Therefore, I will skip this one. And an analysis of dynamics of growth of production of industrial and consumer products, taking into account the project of the company, of oil company, and without it, showed signs of so-called Dutch disease in the Russian economy. And the implementation of the project will lead to structural shifts in the gross output of Russian economy in the direction of increasing the share of oil production, engineering and construction, metallurgy, while reducing the share of industries producing consumer goods and services. And last point, since the technology of oil production in different Russian oil companies is not fundamentally different, the result can be generalized to the oil industry as a whole. An increase in oil production in Russia can lead to positive macroeconomic results only if the additional budgetary revenues are effectively used for investment and development in other sectors of the national economy. Thank you very much for your attention.
Okay, I think we have time for several questions, as long as they're short ones.
A very short comment. Since the only way to make this project effective and efficient for the whole economy is to direct the additional resources into local domestic investments, then the oil companies should buy all their machinery from the local companies. So the American sanctions are the only way that makes us do it. We should be very thankful for them.
Yeah, thank you very much. I agree with this remark. But we did not, in reality, we did not change net export structure. So it was forecast in condition when we have quite big import of equipment. But in oil industry, our partners decreased possibilities to buy equipment for oil and gas industry. Therefore, we have to develop this sector, machine building industry in Russia.
Other questions?
Thank you. Alexander Alex, thank you very much for the presentation. I want to ask a question. Can you use your approach to estimate effectiveness of Yamal SPG project? And how do you think, is it effective when government gives to project operator all possible tax benefits, and also one of infrastructure objects like sea port is built, is financed by government on 75%? Thank you.
Thank you for your question. Yes, I think it's possible to use this approach. Why not? Now we have a methodology and some experience in this field. I think that it's possible.
Other questions? Okay.